Now come to example 5. Show that the function fz is equal to u plus iv, where fz is given as x cube into 1 plus I minus y cube into 1 minus I divided by x square plus y square, z is not 0, and f0 is equal to 0, is continuous. And second, and that Cauchy-Riemann equations are satisfied at the origin, yet f dash 0 does not exist. Let us see its solution. For fz is equal to u plus iv, compare these two equations, then you get u is equal to x cube minus y cube by x square plus y square, and v is equal to x cube plus y cube by x square plus y square, or z non-zero. Since here u and v, they are rational functions of x and y with non-zero denominators, therefore u and v are continuous everywhere when z is non-zero. It is clear. Now to test the continuity at z is equal to 0, change u and v to polars by putting x is equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta. Then what will happen? U will be r cube cos cube theta minus r cube sin cube theta by r square cos cube theta plus r square cos cube theta. Take here r square common, so cos cube theta plus sin cube theta will be 1. So u will be r times cos cube theta minus sin cube theta. Similarly, v is r times cos cube theta plus sin cube theta. Each of which tends to 0 as r tends to 0, whatever may be the value of theta. So we have f of 0 is equal to 0. It is also given u that f of 0 is equal to 0. Since actual and limiting values of u and v are same at origin, therefore, fz is continuous at origin. Hence, fz is continuous for all values of z. Now, at the origin, we have partial differentiation u with respect to x is equal to limit x tending to 0, ux 0 minus u 0 0 divided by x. So it is equal to limit x 0. Ux 0 will be, remember that u is x cube minus y cube by x square plus y square. So substitute y is equal to 0. So u will be, ux 0 will be x cube by x square. It means it is x. And u 0 0 will be 0. So it is x minus 0 by 0. So it is equal to 1. Next, partial differentiation of u with respect to y is equal to limit y tends to 0, u 0 y minus u 0 0 by y. This is equal to limit y tends to 0 and u 0 y. U 0 y will be 0 cube minus y cube by 0 square plus y square. So it is minus y by minus 0 by y. This is equal to minus 1. Similarly, partial differentiation v with respect to x will be limit x tending to 0, vx 0 means x cube plus 0 cube by x square plus 0 square, so it is x minus v 0 0 is 0 by x, so it is equal to 1. And partial differentiation v with respect to y is limit y tends to 0, y minus 0 by y, this is equal to 1. Now from these four, you can see that ux is equal to vy, and ui minus 1 is equal to minus times vx. Therefore, u and v satisfy Cauchy-Riemann equations at origin. Now we have f dash 0 is given as limit z tends to 0, fz minus f0 by z. So this is limit z tends to 0, x cube minus y cube plus I times x cube plus y cube by x square plus y square. This is our fz minus f0 and divided by z. So it is 1 by x plus iy. Now take z tending to 0 along y is equal to x. Then f dash 0 will be limit x tends to 0. Substitute y is equal to x here. So it is 0. It is 2x cube into I. So I into 2x cube by 2x square into 1 by x plus ix. So xx cancels in the numerator and denominator. So it is I by 1 plus I. It means 1 upon 2, 1 plus I. After taking z tending to 0 along x-axis, we get along x-axis y is 0. So So substitute here y is equal to 0. So it will be f dash 0 is equal to limit x tend to 0 x cube plus I x cube by x square into 1 by x, y is 0 here. So it is 1 plus I. Now you can see that f dash 0 has different values along different curves. First along y is equal to x, it is this one. And next along x axis, this is equal to this one. So both of them are different, and therefore f dash 0 does not exist. You can see there is one more example. Examine the nature of the function f that is equal to x square y to the power 5 into x plus I y by x to the 4 plus pi to the power 10 z not 0 and f 0 is equal to 0 in a region including origin. So you can do it yourself. It is not a tough problem. There are so many examples I have solved before you. Now see example 7. Show that the function fz is equal to e to the power minus z to the power minus 4, z not equal to 0, and f0 is equal to 0 is not analytic at z is equal to 0, although the Cauchy-Riemann equations are satisfied at that point. See its solution. We have fz is given as e to the power minus z to the whole power minus 4. So it can be written as e to the power minus 1 by x plus i y to the power 4. Substitute z is equal to x plus i y, so it will be x plus i y to the power minus 4 or 1 by x plus i y to the power 4. It can be written as e to the power minus x minus i y to the power 4 by x square plus y square to the power 4. Multiply here into this fraction, numerator and denominator, by x plus y I to the power 4, x minus i y to the power 4. So you get e to the power minus x minus i y to the power 4. And in the denominator, x plus i y into x minus i y is x square plus y square to the power 4. Now this is equal to e to the power minus, expand this one by binomial expansion. So we will get e to the power minus x power 4 plus y to the power 4 minus 6 x square y square minus 4 I x cube y plus 4 I x y cube by x square plus y square to the whole power 4. Or this is equal to e to the power minus x power 4 plus y to the power minus 6 x square y square by r to the power 8. Separate this one. R to the power 8 means this. X square plus y square is r square. To the power 4 means r to the power 8. So this portion is separate, this portion. And this is minus minus plus. E to the power 4 I x y. Take common 4 I x y from these two. So it will be x square minus y square by r to the power 8, where x square plus y square is your r square. Now, this is equal to e to the power minus x to power 4 plus y to the power 4 minus 6 x square y square by r to the power 8 into this one is, you remember, e to the power I theta is cos theta plus I sin theta. So it is just the same. It will be cos 4xy x square minus y square by r to the power 8 plus I sin 4xy x square minus y square by r to the power 8. Now we have at the origin partial differentiation with respect to x. It will be limit x tending to 0 ux 0 minus u 0 0 by x. So this is equal to limit x tending to 0, ux 0. Ux 0 means here substitute y is equal to 0. In this portion also y is equal to 0, so it will be cos 0 means 1. Here y is equal to 0 means e to the power minus x to the power minus 4. So x tending to 0, e to the power minus x to the power minus 4 by x to the, since it is r to the power 8, means it will be x to the power 8. Here x to the power 4, so it will be x to the power minus 4, minus 0 by x. So it is equal to limit x tending to 0 1 upon x e to the power I x to the power 4. So it is equal to limit x tending to 0 1 by x into expand this one. So 1 plus 1 by x to the power 4 plus 1 by 2 x to the power 8 plus 1. See, now this is equal to limit x tending to 0 1 by x plus 1 by x cube plus 1 by 2 x to the power 7 plus 1. X tending to 0, this is 0. And all of these are infinity. So 1 by infinity, this is equal to 0. So ux is your infinity. Similarly, uy means partial differentiation u with respect to y. It will be limit y tending to 0, u 0 y minus u 0 0 by y. So u 0 y will be, substitute here x is equal to 0 and y will remain only. So it is, these two terms gone. It will be e to the power minus y to the power minus 4. So it is this one. And this is your 0, cos 0, cos 0 is 1. So it is minus 0, e to the power minus y to the power minus 4. This is your 0 by y. So it is equal to 0. Similarly, partial differentiation with respect to x is zero, and partial differentiation with respect to y is zero. Therefore, Cauchy-Riemann equations are satisfied at origin. Next, f dash zero is limit z tending to zero, fz minus f zero z. This is limit z tending to zero, e to the power minus z to the whole power minus 4 by z. Since f zero is zero and fz is this one, so it is equal to limit r tending to zero e to the power minus r to the power minus 4 e to the power minus I pi, taking z tending to zero along, z is equal to r e to the power i pi by 4. And divided by z, substitute the value of z, r into e to the power I pi by 4. So it is equal to limit r tending to zero, denominator remains the same, and it is e to the power minus, e to the power, this is e to the power minus I pi is minus 1, so e to the power, r to the power minus 4, minus 1 ho jayega plus 1, e to the power r to the power minus 4, so it is equal to limit r tending to zero, e to the power 1 by r to the power 4 by r, e to the power I pi by 4 tending to infinity, therefore fz is not analytic at z is equal to 0. So this is all about from complex numbers. Next, we have completed 2 units of complex number, your first paper, and